5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The appellant was thus held guilty also of causing the knife injury to Rakesh and came to be convicted under Section 324 in addition to Section 302 of the Penal Code. Under Section 324, he was sentenced to rigorous imprisonment for 1 year. He was also convicted under Section 25 of the Arms Act by a separate judgment of the Trial Court dated February 2, 1998 in Session Case Number 26 of 1993 and sentenced to the period of imprisonment already undergone as under trial. Against the two judgments of the Trial Court, 3 appeals were filed in the High Court. The High Court, by the judgment and order coming under appeal, dismissed all the 3 appeals and the revision and thus upheld the judgments of the Trial Court in all aspects. Mr. Sahai, senior advocate appearing for the appellant, assailed the High Court and the Trial Court judgments and contended that the appellant's conviction for the offense of murder was not sustainable both in the law and on facts. Mr. Sahai submitted that there were at least 4 circumstances that falsified and completely demolished the prosecution case. First, there was a patent contradiction between the prosecution case and the motive assigned by it to the accused for committing the crime. Secondly, it was undeniable that injuries were fabricated both on the person or the deceased, and Rakesh, the only eyewitness whose evidence was accepted by the High Court. At the time when the plea was raised before the High Court that the impugned order are vitiated on account of the non-supply of inquiry report, it would have been appropriate for the High Court to examine the averments made in the writ petition. A perusal of the writ petition would show that the petitioner has failed to lay any foundation to establish that any prejudice has been caused by the non-supply of the inquiry report. No prejudice was actually caused to the respondent. There was no failure of justice in the facts and circumstances of the case by non-supply of the inquiry report to the respondent. The punishment imposed on the respondent cannot be said to be disproportionate to the gravity of the charges proved against the respondent. The charges related to the conduct of the respondent in a financial institution whereby he procured pecuniary benefits for himself.